We want to solve the given equations and inequality expressed using function notation using the provided graph. Number one, we have f of x equals 0. Well, f of x is this red line here, so we want to know when this function is equal to 0. Remember, f of x is equal to y, so we want to find the point on this red line when the y coordinate is equal to 0. Well, y is equal to 0 all along the x-axis. So the x-intercept at this point here represents when the function value would be 0, and therefore our solution is the x-coordinate of x equals 3. So we're expressing our solution only in terms of x because our equation is written using a function of x. Number two, we want to solve the equation f of x equals g of x. Well, two functions are equal when they share the same point or when they intersect. So again, going back to our graph, these two functions intersect at this point here with an x-coordinate of negative 1 and a y-coordinate of positive 2. But again, because the equation is expressed using functions of x, we only want the x-coordinate of this point of intersection, which we can see would be x equals negative 1. Again, we don't want to give our solution as the point negative 1, comma 2, because our equation is written using functions of x. And now for number 3, we have an inequality. We want to solve the inequality f of x greater than g of x, which graphically means we want to determine the x-interval for which f of x will be above g of x. Well, we discovered they were equal when x was negative 1, but notice how to the left of negative 1, this interval here along the x-axis, notice how the red line is above the blue line, therefore this is the interval for which f of x is greater than g of x, expressed using x. So as we move to the left, we'd be approaching negative infinity. So if we want to express the solution using interval notation, we'd have the interval from negative infinity to negative 1. Again, open on negative 1 because we don't want to know when f of x equals g of x, only when it's greater than g of x. We could also express this using inequalities. That would just be x is less than negative 1. Okay, I hope this explanation helps.